This is Hidden Killers Week in Review.
A look back at the most prolific stories of the week.
Behind every locked door is a story waiting to be uncovered. This is Hidden Killers with Tony Brueski, featuring psychotherapist and author Siobhan Scott.
Matthew Perry, the investigation into his death continues on, and five arrests have now been made in that, including two doctors, Dr. Salvador Placenia and Dr. Mark Chavez, who were involved in supplying the drug. Also, his personal assistant, Kenneth Iwamasa, arrested, and several other individuals as well, including Javina Sangha, otherwise known as the Ketamine Queen. Lots of people involved in enabling the death of Matthew Perry. Joining me to discuss, Siobhan Scott, psychotherapist and author. Were you surprised at this, at just how much of a ring was kind of surrounding him? And it wasn't just him having a doctor here or there that he kind of got some extra. It seems like there was, this is almost like a coordinated effort of, they know they got somebody who's got a lot of money who will buy this stuff far higher than the going rate.
Yeah, I can't say I'm surprised. I have a friend who's a director in Hollywood, and one of the early messages I got when this came out, she wrote and said, I see this kind of stuff going on all the time. And it's just tragic. You know, there's so much hype around ketamine right now, and they're even using it. It's being used for anxiety, depression, PTSD, and they're even using it as a treatment for addiction, which is crazy when you consider that ketamine is an addictive drug. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a Schedule 3 drug. It can kill you in large doses. And so I think we're looking at something really, immoral and morbid, and the profiteering going on. I'd love to say it surprised me, but it doesn't surprise me.
Let's talk about ketamine itself. I mean, we've been hearing that term quite a bit lately of being used for those sort of purposes. And, you know, when prescribed by a doctor, a lot of people think, okay, well, it must be good. Yeah. That's not always the case. But let's talk about ketamine in general. What does it do? Why is it kind of caught on and is somewhat in vogue right now as being a go-to drug for all those things that you just listed?
Yeah, I'm starting to get a bad attitude about it. I can tell you, I tried to be open-minded when we had so much in the press. And I really think that's what we're looking at. We're looking at publicity that started off by somebody who wrote a book about psychedelic drugs basically curing everything. I can't remember the author's name, but it came out about 5 years ago and I read it. And since then, it's been picked up by the media and gotten so much hype. They're actually calling it a brain vitamin and saying that it can cure all these different mental illnesses, sometimes in only one session. That's nonsense. It's just nonsense. It's an anesthetic. It's been used safely for many years in a clinical setting as an anesthetic. But this basically street use or off-label use, I think, comes with a lot of dangers and pitfalls. The thing that I'm seeing, because it's legal in California and Oregon by mail, and I think probably in all 50 states now. So people are doing these at-home lozenges. So they get, I think, 30 lozenges. I've got 2 or 3 clients right now on that program. It's not through me, certainly, but they're just signing up online with a doctor. They have a telehealth visit. And then they get, I think it's 30 lozenges in the mail at the beginning of every month. Well, there's no one monitoring. Are they taking the one a day that they're supposed to take? Or are they taking 5? Are they taking 10? You know, we don't know. And what are the effects if they take 5 or 10? And I think that's what you saw with Matthew Perry. He took enough to put him into an anesthetic state, basically in a deep sleep, and then was in a hot tub alone, you know? So there's crazy stuff going on. And I can't say that I'm seeing in my own clients, now this is not a research study, but in my own clients, I'm not seeing any improvement in their mental health symptoms. Sometimes we'll have a session. And in one case, this is happening in a doctor's office where she gets an IV and goes into her ketamine altered consciousness. And then they put an iPad up in front of her. And I talk to her about her therapy issues and relaxing and all these different things while she's under the influence of the drug. And this is what these programs encourage, is that you can meet with your therapist, and then it's considered ketamine therapy. I'm noticing that people feel better when they're under the influence. But when they're not under the influence, they're back to their same old brain. They're mm-hmm. still having the same depression, the same anxiety. It's not curing any of it. So I'm going to have to be convinced by a lot of good firm clinical evidence that we're actually helping people here and not killing people in some cases.
I mean, is it being used more as a Band-Aid than anything? Is it being used? I mean, one would go, well, is it less dangerous than alcohol, which, you know, a lot of people go to that. But again, if you do too much of that, that'll kill you too.
Same thing. Same thing. You know,
And is this an addictive drug? And is it one in which you have to kind of keep amping up the dose as you go along because it's not going to have the same sort of effect?
Yeah, it's not as addictive as an opioid, but it is addictive. And so a person does have to use it repeatedly. But with someone like Matthew Perry, this guy had been an addict since he was 14 years old. I mean, he just had raging polysubstance dependence. I have complete empathy for the guy. I think he did detox like 65 times. He had attended thousands of AA meetings. This guy was just vulnerable. And I wonder, did one of these doctors sell him on the idea that this is legitimate treatment for the fact that you're an addict without the piece that, you know what, you can become addicted to this too. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's of course, just like alcohol, people die from alcohol poisoning or cirrhosis all the time.
Yeah.
And I think we're going to be seeing more ketamine deaths. I don't know if we're even monitoring the numbers of people that are having Matthew Perry incidents right now, but I'm very concerned about it. And so a lot of people call me asking if I'm supportive of it. Well, if it's legal, if people really want to try it, if it's medically supervised, I'm not going to try and talk them out of it because we don't know. But my personal belief is we need to be really careful with this. And is it being used as a Band-Aid? I think so. People who are really legitimately suffering with mental health conditions often want a quick fix. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, like in the case of psychosis or schizophrenia, there are pretty quick fixes with antipsychotic medication. Sure. And some people are transformed by it. But unfortunately, with so many things, we don't have quick fixes. And I don't think ketamine is going to be it.
You're in the thick of a true crime saga, every detail sinking in. And then, wham, a commercial about something you couldn't care less about. It's like being served a microwaved dinner at a five-star restaurant. But it doesn't have to be this way. Go for True Crime Today, Premium Plus, on Apple Podcasts. With True Crime Today, Premium Plus, you get uninterrupted, ad-free episodes, extended interviews that dig even deeper into the muck, and early access so you can brag to your friends. It's like ordering the secret menu at a crime buffet. So, search for True Crime Today, Premium Plus, on Apple Podcasts. Subscribe and savor every twisted detail without interruption.